It's Monday and it's day two of Schoolies, and we've just come down. We've had lots of really great conversations with people. Spoken to a lot of young ladies today that have gone through the Catholic system and not really understood the gospel. Spoke to a couple of Taiwanese young ladies who understood the gospel, were able to repeat it back to us, and understood the cost. Even though that to go to heaven is free, it could cost them in this world to trust in Jesus.
Today, Beck and I just went up and we were just looking around, and we're looking around and we're like, oh, the team pretty much has everyone sorted down here. So we walked up a little bit further up there, and we eventually started chatting with this guy, and he's quite smart. He was getting everything very quickly. But what we came to really realize was the fact that he didn't want to admit that there was a God, because it would mean that all the good things he's done was for nothing. And he's just consistently like, nope, I don't believe, what's the point of it? And he would jump to other topics, and we just kept trying to get back to the main issue of, hey, what is going to happen to you? And so eventually we had to wrap up the conversation. We're like, hey, well, it is what it is. And we ended, left him with a tract and walked off. And it's not
I had a conversation with a guy, Brody, and it turns out that two others in our team had already talked to Brody for 45 minutes. He was resistant. He wanted to refuse that God existed because he wanted to live his life his own way. And he was really, really proud about that. So he was up for a fight. And Ryan came free and came and joined in. 20 minutes before the end of the conversation with Ryan, Brody, without realizing it, freely admitted that there was a God. He didn't like God, he wanted to live his life his own way. But Ryan persisted because we wanted him to understand the gospel. At this moment in time, that pride was stopping him from submitting to the reality of God and the reality of sin, and resisting the good news, the free offer of eternal life by the sacrifice of Jesus Christ. We pleaded with him. And we're hoping and praying that Brody will have time to think about this, God willing, that he will become humble enough to know that there is no hope other than in Jesus Christ, and that he would submit his knee before he dies, and he would accept that gift of the sacrifice of Jesus Christ. Please be praying for Brody.